we just pray that you will bless them, that you will nurture their life together, and that this time and ceremony will honor and fit to you. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Follow him, though his ways are hard and steep, and when his wings enfold you, yield to him. Though the sword hidden among his pinions may wound you, and when he speaks to you, believe in him. Though his voice may shatter your dreams as the north wind lays waste the garden. For even as love crowns you, so shall he crucify you. Even as he is for your growth, so is he for your pruning. Even as he ascends to your height and caresses your tenderest branches that quiver in the sun, so shall he descend to your roots and shake them in their clinging to the earth. Like sheaves of corn, he gathers you unto himself. He threshes you to make you naked. He sifts you to free you from your husks. He grinds you to whiteness. He kneads you until you are pliant. And then he assigns you to his sacred fire, that you may become sacred bread for God's sacred feast. All these things shall love do unto you, that you may know the secrets of your heart, and in that knowledge become a fragment of life's heart. But if, in your fear, you would seek only love's peace and love's pleasure, then it is better for you that you cover your nakedness and pass out of love's threshing floor into the seasonless world, where you shall laugh, but not all of your laughter, and weep, but not all of your tears. Love gives not but itself, and takes not but from itself. Love possesses not, nor would it be possessed, for love is sufficient unto love. When you love, you should not say, God is in my heart, but rather, I am in the heart of God.
You're saying to each other, as Ruth said to Naomi, where you go, I will go. Where you stay, I will stay. Your people will be my people. Your God will be my God. Where you die, I will die. The marriage is not just between the two of them. In a sense, you're marrying each other's families. Your family is now bigger and better. You marry each other's church and their church families. You marry each other's communities in which you grew up in and which have molded and shaped you. In a sense, you even marry each other's friends who have had such an important part of who you are and support you here this afternoon. All this can be a very positive thing, or it can also drive a wedge between you. But I believe because you have chosen to have a public wedding, a public and a Christian wedding, these differences will be your strengths and will strengthen your marriage and make it to be an awesome relationship. I'm reminded of a little boy who was told that he could have a puppy for his birthday. And so, after the birthday celebrations, they went down to the pet store. And there were all these puppies running around there, and the little boy looked at them, and he looked at all the different colors and shapes. And then he noticed one that just seemed to be wagging his tail all the time. Just didn't stop the whole time he was there. And finally, after looking at all of them and touching them and petting them, he chose the one who seemed the friendliest to him. And his mother asked him, so why did you pick that one? And he said, I chose that one because it has the happy ending. I invite you to turn around and look and see who is here this afternoon. These people believe in you. These people are praying for you. These people love you. These people have committed to stand by and encourage you. I believe that it is their earnest prayer that your marriage will have a happy ending. But marriage takes work. It doesn't always turn out as you dream it might be. Tony Campola tells a story of Robertson McQuilly. His father was president of Columbia Bible College. And as a small boy, Robertson dreamed that someday he too would be president of Columbia Bible College. And after many years and getting married, he was called by the college to be president. And he served faithfully there for a number of years. And then suddenly his wife was diagnosed with a rapidly advancing Alzheimer's disease. And soon it became very evident that she no longer knew him anymore. And he decided to resign and care for his wife. Many people criticized him for that. They said to Robertson, "There's only a few people that have your skills and abilities to run Columbia Bible College. But there are many people who can care for your wife who doesn't even know you and remember who you are." And this was his answer, and this is what I want you to remember this afternoon. He said, "Though she does not know me, I still know her. And I see in her the woman that I love and that I married years ago." And he went on to say, "More important than that, yes, I was called to be president of Columbia Bible College, but there's one thing that is more important than a calling, and that's a promise. And I promise to love my wife and to cherish and care for her. Because it is God who is that third strand in a very strong cord. With God in that center, your marriage will truly have a happy ending. I invite you now to say your vows to one another. Today, Wally and Kristin stand before us in a desire to publicly declare their love and to share with us their marriage promises. Wally, please repeat your promises after me. I, Wally King, take you, Kristin Nolan, to be my wife. I promise to love you, Kristin. I promise to be faithful to you.
I promise to be faithful to you.
In thought, word, and act.
In thought, word, and act.
I promise to love you with all my heart, mind, and strength.
I promise to love you with all my heart, mind, and strength.
I promise to offer you, comfort, encouragement, and companionship. For all the days of my life. Kristin, please repeat after me. I, Kristin Nolan, take you, Wally King, to be my husband. I promise to love you, Wally, with all my heart, mind, and strength. I promise to be faithful to you.
In thought, word, and act.
I promise to consider your welfare and happiness. Before I make any decisions. I promise to offer you comfort and encouragement.
I promise
as a symbol of my love and my promise.
A symbol of my love and my promise.
Kristin, will you repeat after me? Wally, I give you this ring as a symbol of my love and my promise. Blessed Heavenly Father, I'd like to present to you, and it's my great pleasure, Mr. and Mrs. Wally and Kristin.